Shin Toiz Aikido, Mind and Body Oneness Aikido. First, we teach how to coordinate mind and body, but how to use body and mind with it. Very safe and develop slowly. Not just physically, but mentally, gradually have confidence to do what they do. Then gradually we develop skill. Calmness in action. That means no matter how fast you move or how aggressively move around, still you have center. That's what we're trying to show through our movement. Two rules for mind, two rules for body. For mind, mental side is first keep our center. The way is center become very crucial for our own activity. Of course, by thinking wise, you can think any place as center. But if you think any place as center, it's all in your head. But that's not how balance is. Nobody balance by head. Head too heavy. But anyway, the higher balance is physically, is the body doing. Where the center of the body balance is like a lower abdomen. Second is we call extend the kick. Very common question for beginners. How could I extend the kick, sensei? But we just, that's an expression. Extend the kick means many ways. If you feel very cheerful, or you must be extending ki. If you feel healthy, or you must be extending ki. If you so motivated, okay, I want to do something, you must be extending ki. The extending ki means more like that way. Doesn't have to kind of visualize what ki go out on. More like a feeling. Feeling from the inside, but throughout the body. Another two principles. As a little more physical, is relax completely. We say relax, but relax completely. Taking break, but not stopping ki. Ki continue flow. Take all unnecessary baggage or strength out. That's why I feel very great. Second one for physical side is weight underside. This is a basic principle that both mind and body, if you relax, the natural settle down because we have gravity. That's easy to forget. We are surrounded by gravity. Then once the body settle, mind naturally settle. if you let the mind go, you can relax and you can have a calmness. But hard to do, right? We're trying to worry too much with the mind, and then trying to fix mind so much. But the more you try, it's getting worse. Then instead of fix our mind directly, ask body to wait on the side. Hagigiri is one kind of activity we do, mind-body coordination part of training. It's very useful for many individuals, and that's part of that part is very applicable to our daily life. Way of Aikido is applicable, that's like a way of life, but technique is not that much useful. Most people don't need any Aikido technique when you walk up. Person who cannot walk well, there's no Aikido anyway. But the mind-body coordination teach people to how to walk well, how to stand well, how to behave well with life, not just to specialize as martial arts. I can concentrate. I have power of my mind with my body. That can be very useful. When you need it, you can concentrate. Not just to tight concentrate, relax, but very concentrate and powerful. It's very useful for in a real life. Physical side of Aikido is very suitable for any ages. A person who's not really physically active, and well, even I'm not so good with any sports. Aikido is very suitable for them. Just practice. Don't worry about it. Any concept, don't worry about anything with the mind. You have to have a good attitude to learn, but anything else go follow naturally when you practice. Shinshin towards Aikido, what is mind and body coordination? Aikido as arts center with activity. Ki itself is life, life force. The person who has more appreciative life actually do well in Aikido.